Welcome to another session of wireless communications and networks unit 2 mobile data propagation large scale path loss. Right, now we're discussing about topic on relating power to electric field. Nothing but you know the relation between power, resistance, voltage, current. That is the power which is equal to V square by R. You know the relation P equal to V square by R. Based upon this concept, now we are going for how the power is related to electric field. Right. Suppose we have to assume that this is a radiating structure, a cylindrical radiating structure, which is fixed on place coincided with Z axis. We are taking coordinates X, Y, Z. X, Y, Z are the coordinates for the system, right? We are fixing this radiating structure coincided with along Z axis. Here, the radiating structure length is capital L, nothing but other it is called linear radiator. Linear radiator. Here, whenever the current passes through this linear radiator, is I naught. Whenever the current is passes, which produce electromagnetic fields. Electric field moves towards to the this current flows. Magnetic field is perpendicular to electric field. At that time, we are getting the coordinates are R. R is nothing but radiating power. Whenever here the P is the point where exactly we are using receiver. The distance between transmit receiver is D. And the angle between from Z axis to radiating power is theta. And phi is phi. That is now we are calculating based upon the coordinates R, theta, comma, phi. Nothing but here whenever the current passes through the along the Z axis. What are the field components are present? ER, E theta, H phi. ER, E theta, H phi. H phi. Similarly, whenever HR equal to H theta, which is equal to E phi, which is equal to zero. You know the concept of electromagnetic fields. Electromagnetic theory based upon electromagnetic theory. Right from this picture, right here we are getting the current flows through the such antenna, which launches electric and magnetic fields. That is ER, E theta, H phi. Similarly, HR, H theta, E phi, which is equal to zero. Here, see this equation number 10, 11, 12. It depends upon the I naught, nothing but current, amplitude, what is L here, the losses which we are getting, and how much angle the radiation which flows, right? And it depends upon the 1 by D and 1 by D square and 1 by D cube like this. Here, what is 1 by D in these equations, which represent radiation field component. Radiation field component, that is how much radiation we are getting in a particular direction. 1 by D square term represents induction field component. Induction field component. Next, 1 by D cube term represents the electrostatic field component. Electrostatic field component. Right. Suppose we had assumed that far field region, nothing but the distance between transmitter to receiver is in terms of kilometers. At that time, the electrostatic and induction fields become negligible, right? Whenever the distance between transmitter and receiver increases, we have to neglect that magnetic fields for problems we are getting. That is induction and electrostatic fields are neglected. Only we have to consider radiation field component. Then the above equation, we have to neglect 1 by D square, 1 by D cube terms are negligible. then only E theta and H phi should be considered. That is equation 11 and 12 should be considered. Automatic equation number should be neglected. Right. Now we are calculating power flux density. Power flux density, that is PD, in terms of W by meter square. Power flux density. That is the power flux density, which is equal to EIRP divided by 4 pi T square. What is meant by EIRP? Effective isotropic radiated power. You know the equation for EIRP, which is equal to PT GT. Then substitute PT GT here. Then the power flux density, which is equal to PT GT by 4 pi T square. Then we had to easy modification of this one is E square plus E square by RFS. Otherwise, E square by lambda. Here, what is meant by RFS is nothing but intrinsic impedance for a free space. Intrinsic impedance for a free space, which is equal to eta, which is equal to 120 by 120 pi ohm or 377 ohm. Then, power flux density, which is given by power flux density, which is equal to modulus of E square divided by 377 ohm watts per meter square. Here, what is meant by modulus of E? Modulus of E represents the magnitude of radiation portion of the electric field. Magnitude of radiation portion of the electric field with a far distance. Right. Suppose we have to assume that PD, power flux density, may be thought as the EARP divided by surface area of a sphere with a radius D. With a radius D. Nothing but see this one. This is about first picture. Power flux density is the distance of D. Nothing but this is a transmitting antenna. So if we had assumed that this is the receiving antenna portion, the distance transmitter receiver is D. Right? Here the transmitting antenna power and gain is PTZT. PTZT multiplication, which is equal to EIRP. EIRP. Right. Here nothing but the power received at the distance is D and PR of D is given by power flux density times effective aperture of the receiving antenna. Right. Suppose we have to draw the equivalent circuit for the receiving antenna. Suppose we are taking one antenna. Suppose to work the particular antenna, nothing but we are giving some power, right? Similarly, to draw the equivalent circuit for receiving antenna is nothing but this is the receiver antenna whose voltage is V. To give a power to this receiver, that is V ant. Voltage for antenna, it is open circuit. The resistance of this circuit, we have to equivalent circuit is R ant, resistance of the antenna. Here from this figure B, that is model for voltage applied to input of a receiver. From this figure, the received power D is equal to PD into AE. What do you mean AE here? Aperture, effective aperture, then which is equal to modulus of E square divided by 120 pi multiplied with AE, which is equal to PTGTGR lambda square by 4 pi square D square. Nothing but here that the simple equation which is related to free space equation. That is free space equation. We can calculate for different manners. Directly from the values, or we had to calculate power flux density and effective aperture. Also had to calculate free space equation. Right. Suppose we are now assume that the above model of a antenna, which we input of this antenna is is V ant. From this above figure, capital V shows RMS voltage at the input of a receiver. R ant shows the resistance of a matched receiver, and V ant shows voltage of a for a matched receiver. Then the received power, which is equal to V square by R ant. You know the general equation of P V R is P equal to V square by R. Similarly, the received power P R of D, which is equal to V square by R ant, which is equal to here the V is nothing but RMS voltage. RMS voltage, nothing but you know V ant value. Then how to calculate V RMS, which is equal to V ant by 2. That's why V ant by 2 whole square divided by R ant. Then which is equal to V ant square divided by 4 R ant. This is another way to calculate received power whenever it is under open circuit. Open circuit. Suppose whenever the V, that is RMS voltage, which is equal to V and nothing but when there is no load. This is about how electric field relating to power, that is based upon V value, V and P. Right. Do you have any query? Type your query in the chat box. Thank you. Thank you very much for attending today's session.